Okay, now let's move on to the next kind of variation of this problem, which is bonus and penalty. We want to now include bonus and penalty, okay, and all of you are aware that in many contracts there is bonus and penalty clauses in it based on what the owner requires, and typically it's on a daily or on a weekly basis, saying if you finish so many days ahead, we give you a bonus. If you finish so many days late, it's a penalty. And the reason for this is the owner, if he gets a facility early, can actually generate revenue out of the facility. So passes on a little bit of that to the contractor, or in the other side, if he actually cannot use the facility, he loses money and he penalizes the contractor for this. And this is certainly an incentive for the contractor to be able to try to finish earlier. So if we take a problem of which is given here, so we have given a precedence relationship. You have an activity, the predecessor, normal duration, crash duration, all of these usual information. In addition, I have given you an indirect cost of 400, and this is the addition now. If the project finishes within normal duration, there is no bonus or no penalty. If each excess day, there is a 300 day penalty, and each reduced day, there is a 300 day bonus. Okay, so can you set up this network and start working on it? We will solve it. So it's fairly, so if we I mean, you might have used a tabulation or you might have used the network.
Network,
you know, so setting up the tabulation takes little more time. For a problem of this nature, I would suggest you can use the network. So we would do 0, 0, 20, 60, 140 is where the, okay, again I am not going to do the backward pass, let us just go through it. The critical path is BCDE, so it goes through, okay. So if I want to reduce duration, I have to crash one of these, okay. So what are my options?
D,
okay, D at 60, okay, it is so much less than the others, and by how much can I? By 10 days, if I take it by 10 days, I am safe, right? Nothing else becomes critical meanwhile. So I take D, I make it 20, and this goes to 80. Okay, you can keep, you must keep track of the cost, okay. We will show the tabulation of the cost in the end, so I am not going to write it down, we will go through, but there will be a cost. Obviously D is 60 into 10 600, okay, so it will be 600, and D is also crashed out to the max, so I cannot take D anymore. What would be next, and my, what is my critical path now? Yes, now I have B, C, D, E and B, F. So any change now, any so my combi, now this is the important part. What are the combinations? So if you miss a combination and you do not calculate the cost of the combination, then you miss the whole thing. So you have to actually look at the combinations, and to see the combinations you can either go to the table, or here you can just look at the network. So if I take B, one of the advantages is it will pull both paths, okay, because it is part of both paths, right. But right now B is 400, C, if I take C, I have to take C and F, or even if I take E, it will affect both paths, okay. So my option is E at 120, B at 400, or C and F at, what is that, 900. Okay, so I will go with E, and how much can I reduce E by?
10
by 10 days, I can go the full 10 days. Okay, this goes to 120. Now what's happened? Activity A has also become critical. So now I have all three paths in the, all three paths becoming critical, and any further crashing will require
combination.
Will require A also to be able to, okay, and A being independent of everything else, it has to be a part of all other paths, all other combinations, okay. So I can, for example, have A and B, so now E is also gone out of contention. I have A and B or ACF, okay. So AB or ACF, so AB is 600, AB is 500, ACF is certainly more, okay. So I will go with A and B. How much can I move A by, and how much can B? Can only go by 5, so I am limited to that 5. So I move B to 15, and A can't go more than, can't write at this step, I can't take it more less than 5, okay. So it's at 150. So here we go to 15, and here I have taken it to 115. Okay, with that B has also gone out of contention. I am only left with ACF. How much can I reduce ACF? What is the maximum? C is limiting, C can go down to 10 days, so I will go take, so everything can go down to 10 days only. So this goes to 30, where are we, 50, okay. I should have actually done this path before, but we know that they are all critical. Okay, so you can, we can put the costs associated with each. Let us just go to the table because I have the cost there. Okay, so you will find that this is the steps you have taken. Okay, and we had a normal duration, then we reduced D. Okay, and then we reduced E to not biz not by 20, but it's 220. Okay, we reduced E to 40. Okay, then we reduced A to 115 and B to 15, and then in the last step we took A, C, and F and reduced it. And we have the direct cost shown in the table for each. And yeah, so then in this column here we show how the direct cost increases with each step. Okay, now in the next column we have the total indirect cost. We said 400 per day, and we have it as each as the period decreases, obviously the indirect cost will reduce, and then finally we have the total cost, and this follows us our pattern which we are used to in this kind of relationship. And we say that this is where the minimum is. So far we have not included the bonus and penalty. Okay, so now what happens? Remember, bonus and penalty is
if it's delayed or if it's done ahead of the schedule.
Right. So we had a value of, how much did we say the bonus and penalty was? 300 per day. Okay, remember it was 300 per day. Now can you do the calculation? Can you add the bonus and penalty to this and see what, how would you add this to this and see how would the results differ?
It's just 20 into 300.
No, we need to know the schedule first.
Yeah, so we are, so now we are taking, if we say, so if we take 100, so our normal duration is 140, so if it is 140 there is no bonus, no penalty. Okay, if it is 130, 10 days of bonus. Okay, so it'll go to 3000. It'll be plus. If it is goes to 120, it'll be another 3000. Okay, now what if I exceed 140? If I go to 150, correct. So my question is, given this cost structure, do you see any change in where the bonus will take place, or any change in where the minimum cost will take place? Minimum total cost of the project. Any, what is the influence of the bonus? So let's look at the table. This is how the bonus structure puts in. So if I have 150, I have 140, which is my normal duration, which is zero. The minute I exceed, I go higher. That is fine. As I start going lower, as my project duration starts decreasing, my bonus starts increasing. Okay, but my direct cost is also increasing. Yes. So as my direct, so now I have to take three factors into account: increasing my direct cost, which is depending on the activity I crash, my increasing bonus, which is depending on the bonus rate, my decreasing indirect cost, which is decreasing at the daily rate of the indirect cost, and decreasing with duration, project duration. So if I take all these three into account, this is the minimum value. Okay, so in the earlier case, what was the minimum duration? 120. Okay, so you can now you will see when you add the bonus to the indirect, what is the slope? 700. Right, 400 and 300. Okay, so I am basically reducing it at around 700 per day, and so you will have to take that into account and see where am I actually going to make the difference.
This is from a contractor's perspective.
Now we are looking at it from the contract, and but who makes the contract?
The client.
So the client has decided on the bonus value based on his benefit. So obviously if he finishes early, he is making something also out of it. It is not just the contractor's. Okay, so if there are any questions or discussions on this, we can take any further discussions. Otherwise, just quickly to summarize, we kind of revisited the time cost trade-off procedure. We saw how we have to go through the steps and calculate the minimum direct cost of crashing a network. We then added the indirect cost and then saw the minimum total cost. We kind of introduced a tabular approach for calculation. Okay, we'll do a few more examples on this, and then finally we saw how you can incorporate factors such as bonus and penalty or any other cost that might come in, and it's only an algebraic addition. Okay, so right now we are not looking at it as functions or anything, it's just an algebraic addition, but it has to be done systematically so you can see where your total cost changes and you have to then capitalize on making use of that. Okay, thank you.